This is an SR Alpine Sport. It's a lugged steel mixty that was made in Japan. The bike was purchased by my partner's father for her mother in San Diego, California in 1987. The bike hasn't been much used, and they asked Mel if she'd like to have it. She said yes, and we brought it home. Overall, the bike's in great shape with some cool Suntour Nitto components, but it's not quite set up for comfortable and practical riding. It's overgeared, it has 27-inch wheels on 28mm tires, and could use a couple of upgrades. So the first thing I did was to remove the rear wheel and the brake and attempt to adjust the rear spacing from 126 millimeters to 130. The plan was to use a set of wheels I had on hand that I had pulled off of my Rivendell Sam Hilborn when I first bought it. So I used a homemade spacer, which is a piece of all thread with a few washers and sleeves on it. I had overspanned the back, so I used a clamp to pinch it back into shape. This is a Velocity Synergy 700C, and with a deflated 38mm tire, it just fits. These are Schwabe Marathons. So I started to take the bike apart. Here I'm breaking the chain. And these are really big, heavy platform pedals that are one-sided. I think the gearing on this crankset was something like a 50-40. Just ridiculous. Way overgeared for what we need. This crankset also has an obsolete bolt center diameter, so I couldn't just change the rings and leave the crank. I had to replace the whole crankset. Now here, I'm struggling to remove the crank because I forgot to remove the crank bolt. So, I pulled the crank bolt and then was able to remove the crank arm. And I pulled this rear mech. This is a Suntour ARX. I really like Suntour stuff, so I'd plan to reuse this if I could. Now, these are some cool Suntour stem mount shifters, but Mel didn't want to use them, so we opted to go with thummies. And these are Diacomp brake calipers. They didn't have enough reach for the 700 conversion, so I didn't get to use them. Here I'm removing the broken reflector from the front. And removing the grips with an air compressor. Worked pretty well. The shape of these bars is really similar to an albatross, but they're not quite as big, as wide, or sweep back as much. These are on a Nitto Young stem. It's one of their cheaper stems, at least nowadays. And this bike doesn't have decals. Instead, it has transparent stickers. And they were starting to peel off anyhow, so I went ahead and peeled them off the rest of the way. Here I'm using some Goo Gone on a paper towel to remove more sticker residue. And I find the paper towel holds the solvent in place. And perhaps to the horror of some viewers, yes, I'm using a decal scraper on the paint to remove gunk. Here are all of the new bits that I plan to put on the bike. And I started by taking my wheel set, and I was going to put on new tires. Pull off this old front tire. And here, the rear cassette plum fell off of the wheel. There was no impact. It had just sheared off. So now I needed a new wheel set, but in the meantime, I put the new front tire on the front wheel. This is a Soma Shikoro 33mm. I went with the 33s, but later changed my mind and picked up some 38s. And this is a set of Nitto Albatross bars that I've had for a couple of years. And I'm putting them on a too long 12cm stem. I would later swap out this stem for something shorter. There were many instances of undoing and redoing and swapping components on this build. So here I'm putting on the thumb shifter mounts and the brakes. The thumb shifter mounts are from Velo Orange, and the brake levers are Tektro FL750s. These are Rivendell Silver One shifters. And here I'm installing the brakes. They are Tektro R365s. And they've got the reach for the 700C wheels. The seat post was an odd size. It's a 26.6. I had to track one down on eBay. And this is a used Brooks B17. This is a Sugino GP crankset from an old Bridgestone XO1 that I picked up on the iBob forum. And here I'm adding a 26-tooth inner ring. The outer chain guard is from Blue Lug. It's the 38-tooth size. And the bigger ring is a 34-tooth. Here I've got that Suntour ARX reinstalled. And I overhauled the bottom bracket. Put that back in. Got the crank installed. I ordered another set of wheels. These came from either the Rivendell Owner's Bunch or iBob. It's a set of Mavic Opens with Shimano 105 hubs. I didn't much like the decals, so I decided to remove them and scrape off the excess residue. Just to get it to a clean, simple silver rim. Again, I'm using Goo Gone and a paper towel and letting that set up for a bit. Then cleaning up the rest of the gunk. I started to run cables and housing. Here are some brass bits, some brass cage bolts, and ferrules and cable ends. Started to get the cable housing roughed in. And I started to install the cables. At first, I thought that the inner ring wouldn't work with this front derailleur because it would interfere with the cable. But I was mistaken and later discovered that if I don't run it cross-chain, there won't be any problems. So here's the Suntour ARX that I considered installing, and another Suntour. I can't remember the name of this one. I got the ARX installed. This was original to the bike, and I really wanted to use it, but I found that when I articulated it to the largest ring, it would interfere with the spokes. So I installed a Shimano XT M773. This is a modern XT, and it works great. Got the chain installed. And it shifts all right. Up front, I got that 26 tooth inner ring reinstalled, and it shifts just fine. So next up, I started working on the grips. And I decided to use some wool felt that I got from Rivendell and to do a layer of felt wrapped in cotton Nubom's bar tape. So here I'm measuring the diameter of the felt. And I attached it with 3M Super 77. This is absolutely overkill. Got a nice tight fit for the wool. And then I wrapped it in orange Nubom's. And finished it with some hemp twine. And I shellacked it with amber shellac. The color did not turn out anything like I was hoping for. So I went over top of the orange with brown, and then shellacked that with more amber shellac. And I really didn't like the way that this looked either. I installed some cork stoppers that I got at the hardware store. They fit well. And they cost something like 50 cents a piece. Then I installed a Villa Orange Constructor front rack. And here is the diving board attachment. taking some measurements to try to make some bends to get around that front brake. So I bent that up. And got it installed. I installed a walled 137 basket. These baskets are fantastic, cheap, made in the USA, and easily installed with a set of 4 zip ties. This is a reflective triangle from Blue Lug in Japan. I love these things and I put them on a lot of bikes. Next, I pulled off the little glassine protective label protector deals. Here I'm making a custom brass badge. This is a sort of dedication badge. It's got a little custom message punched into it. So there's the original owner's initials and date, and the current owner's initials and date. I hammer that flat. And this is a jig that I made for bending badges. The diameter of this dowel matches the diameter of a seat tube. And this one bent up okay. Here I'm brushing it with grease and then rubbing it with a piece of charcoal from my wood stove. This is to fill in the letters black. I wiped off the excess. This is some double-sided automotive body tape. Very sticky. And I installed this on the seat tube right above the decal for the bike shop where the bike was originally purchased. Several months passed, and I eventually got around to replacing this stem, which was just too long. I also didn't like the grips, so this gave me an opportunity to swap those out as well. So, unwrapping that brown layer. And the orange too. I'm working hard against that 3M Super 77. Here I'm driving a screw into the cork. And that worked really well for pulling it out. Scraping off some of that excess glue. And pulling that stem. So here is a 6 centimeter stem, same albatross bars. And here I'm cleaning them up as well as I can. Getting the levers and shifters back on the bars. And here I'm using some Permatex gasket seal. This is something that Rivendell recommended in their literature someplace or another. I'm probably using way too much here. It's pretty nasty stuff. And these are the Rivendell Portuguese cork grips. And I applied, I think, 2 layers of amber shellac. Here are the shifters and levers, and the new grips. So after the stem was swapped, I decided to change the 32mm tires for these 38s. These are Panaracer Gravel Kings with the smooth tread and the coffee sidewall. Here I'm pulling those Chicaros. In go the Gravel Kings. Here is a Gravel King side by side with the original 27-inch wheels. Measure actual 28 millimeters, and these measure actual 36 millimeters. I have plenty of clearance up front, but the 38s max out the amount of room I've got in the back. This bike has horizontal dropouts. With vertical dropouts, I think I could fit something as big as a 42. So the wheels are back on. New tires are on. New stem. New grips. Brakes are back on. And this bike is complete. Here are a few finished views of the bike. We've got more practical overall gearing. We've got a nice comfortable leather saddle. Nice wide, long, swept back bars, thumb shifters, a handy basket, a bell, and a nice ride.